from the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel. With the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, the friendship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to the celebration of the daily televised Mass in this first week of Easter. I am Father Michael Coutts. The televising of this Mass is made possible by a contribution from Alice and Joseph Augustine from London, Ontario. This Mass is being offered in loving memory of their son, Tony Augustine. Tony was a loving, kind, and devoted son to his parents. The loss of Tony has been for his parents a source of great sadness. May he have eternal rest in God's loving arms. Our thanks to Alice and Joseph for choosing to remember their son Tony in this way. This sacred celebration will be seen by tens of thousands of people across Canada and around the world, and on their behalf, I thank you. As we prepare ourselves now to celebrate this Eucharist, we ask the Lord, the God of mercy and compassion, to forgive us. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us praise God as we say, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who gave us the Paschal mystery in the covenant you established for reconciling the human race, so dispose our minds that we may celebrate by professing the faith we may express in deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Peter and John were speaking to the people, the priests, the captain of the temple, and the Sadducees came to them, much annoyed because they were teaching the people and proclaiming that in Jesus there is resurrection of the dead. So they arrested them and put them in custody until the next day, for it was already evening. But many of those who heard the word believed, and they numbered about 5,000. The next day their rulers, elders, and scribes assembled in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest, Caiaphas, John, and Alexander, and all who were of the high priestly family. When they had made the prisoners stand in their midst, they inquired, "By what power or by what name did you do this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are questioned today because of a good deed done to someone who was sick, and are asked how this man has been healed, let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel that this man is standing before you in good health by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders. It has become the cornerstone. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among mortals by which we must be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks
Thanks be to God.
Rejected by the builders, has become the cornerstone. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his steadfast love endures forever. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The stone rejected by the builders has become the stone. Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus showed himself again to the disciples by the Sea of Tiberias, and he showed himself in this way. Gathered there together were Simon Peter, Simon called the Twin, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, I am going fishing. And they said to him, we will go with you. They went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Just after daybreak, Jesus stood on the beach, but the disciples did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, children, you have no fish, have you? They answered him, no. He said to them, cast the net to the right side of the boat, and you will find some. So they cast it, and now they were not able to haul it in, because there were so many fish. The disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, it is the Lord. When Simon Peter heard this, that it was the Lord, he put on some clothes, for he was naked, and jumped into the sea. But the other disciples came in the boat, dragging the net full of fish, for they were not far from the land, only about 90 meters. When they had gone ashore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. And Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." So Simon Peter went aboard and hauled the net ashore, full of large fish, 153 of them. And though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." None of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" Because they knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to the disciples after he had been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The disciples came ashore and Jesus was making breakfast for them. Imagine Jesus making breakfast to you, and Peter hauls the fish in and he counts them. And I always wondered, here's Jesus making breakfast and he's counting the number of fish. It sounded rather strange. But Jesus was often seen at a meal, so much so that the scribes and the Pharisees said, "He is a glutton and a drunkard." But there was a reason. Jesus was at meals. Sometimes he would forgive sins. Sometimes he would teach lessons. But most of the times he was there just to relax with friends. Why was this so? Because when you are at meal, you relax. When you are at meal, you put aside your prejudices and your biases. When you are at meals, you relax. You have problems, you have stresses, you have difficulties, you have health problems, but you don't bother about them at that time. You are there to enjoy the company of one another. And so we see Jesus so very often. Jesus, as soon as Matthew, the tax collector, answered his call, "Come follow me," said, "Let's go and have a meal with tax collectors and sinners." He was in Jericho and sees Zacchaeus up in the sycamore tree, and he says, "Zacchaeus, come down. I must eat with you tonight." He sees on the day of Palm Sunday in the evening, he is tired and he's sitting down at the house of Simon the leper, and a woman who was a sinner came and anointed his feet. Jesus must have felt so much relief. And he taught Simon the leper the idea that if you have been forgiven much, you love very much. And then there was Martha and Mary. And Mary, this was for me the crucial idea of having a meal. Martha was so busy doing things, and that's what we do very often at meals. We are busy doing things. But the real thing is to encounter. And this Mary was encountering Jesus, and that is what everything was about. We find that more and more people do not enjoy the Eucharist, and many people think that Jesus is not truly present. The presence of Jesus is symbolic. And I said, well, if the presence of Jesus is symbolic, why would God so love the world? God could just have saved the world without even bothering to send Jesus down so that he could be born in Bethlehem, suffer and die and rise again. There was no need for all of that. But God sent Jesus into the world so we may touch and know and love God. And unfortunately, we have lost that in our meals. The United States of America, the bishops have got together in order to start a Eucharistic revival conference because so few people believe in the actual presence of Jesus. And the reason is pretty simple. We have been so caught up in our devices. You go into a restaurant and you have your cell phone over there, you put it down. Even though it is off and you turn and it is off, what you're telling the people, I'm not bothered with your thoughts, your ideas, your struggles, your joys, your happiness, your dreams. Human beings have been sacrificed on the altar of the cell phone. I took a friend of mine to a restaurant together with his 14-year-old. And as we went in, the 14-year-old said to the restaurant owner, "What is the Wi-Fi?" And I said, "You tell him what the Wi-Fi is, and I'm walking out of here." And we sat down there, and he was a very good baseball, just trying to be a baseball pitcher. And I said, I hear great things about you. And his eyes simply lit up. Here was a 14-year-old full of dreams. And I would not have shared those dreams if he had taken out his cell phone and looked at it. Here we have in our midst people like Matthew and Zacchaeus, people like Martha and Mary, people like Simon the leper and the woman, and we lose them. Why? We are so caught up in our devices. We have sacrificed them, just like the Israelites bowed before a calf made out of their own hands. What difference is between that calf, the golden calf, thousands of years ago in the Exodus experience, and our cell phones today? We bow before them, and we listen to somebody who we don't know from Adam. They take preference over the people around us. Here are people who are going to share with us. What are they going to share? They're going to share the image and the likeness of God in each one of them. But we don't want to listen. We are so bothered. We have lost the ability to look. We have lost the ability to hear. And therefore, when we come to the Eucharist, it's just a piece of bread and just a cup filled with wine. And Jesus says, I'm giving to you the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation. Oh, what a gift, what a wonderful gift. Who can tell the wonder of the Lord? Let us open our eyes and open our hearts. It is Christ the Lord, as is He. If we can't see Jesus in the men and women around us, how can we see a God who is invisible? God bless you all. Join me now as we pray together. For all those in our daily televised Mass intention book, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sponsor of this Mass and for the repose of the soul of Tony Augustine, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Easter season, we offer our community prayer and thanksgiving for the new life that is ours in the risen Christ. May we be strengthened by His healing presence among us so that we may live in peace and glorify Him by our life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, receive all these prayers that we make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My sisters, my brothers, that this our sacrifice be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good.
Perfect within us, O Lord, the solemn exchange brought about by these paschal offerings, that we may be drawn from earthly desires to longing for things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, he has restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her through the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Francis our Bishop, all the clergy, and this entire people of God. Remember also our brothers and sisters. Remember Tony Augustine and all who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Jean de Brebeuf, Isaac Jogues, and our Canadian martyrs, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Wherever you are, let us share a sign of this peace and friendship.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us and all our dear ones unto life everlasting.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, those you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been celebrated. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.